As the rescue operation continues in the areas that were hit by heavy rainfall and flooding that has resulted in deaths and displacement of thousands of people, we continue to give you extensive coverage of the floods. Here is some insight into the flood situation. Over 4,000 houses have been demolished by continued heavy rainfall in Chiradzulu East, leaving 20,000 people homeless. Speaking after visiting the affected families, parliamentarian for the area, Henry Musa, says the people need urgent assistance of various household items, including shelter. Musa spoke to Patrick Tawakali.
Looking at 4,000 households that have been affected, so much so that they have been rendered destitutes, have been rendered completely homeless. Currently, there is an immediate need for food, and I'm making an appeal to all well-wishers, including the donor community, colleagues out there, the business community, to come all and come one and assist in provision of food. We are also desperately looking for shelter. In the shelter, we are appealing for tents, the heavy-duty plastic sheetings. We're also appealing for blankets because majority of them have lost their wares, have lost their clothes, they've lost their blankets.
Mosa, who's also Minister of Labour and Manpower Development, advised local leaders and all those involved in the registration exercise to be impartial in carrying out their work so that the assistance reaches the targeted people. Mosa also advised people to construct houses with a strong foundation.
It's an appeal for the leadership that shall be involved in distribution of the items I'm appealing for to be fair, to be realistic, to target only those that have been affected. Otherwise, we don't want to see or to experience a situation where there's corruption, there's cheating, there's double standards in the process. And that is my appeal to them all, that let there be fairness, let's target only those that have been affected. But also to appeal, I was appealing to them to next time consider constructing these houses with a solid foundation.
And 8 people are feared dead and lives of about 5,000 people are in danger due to heavy floods that wrecked houses, crops and cut off the road network in some parts of Mulanje. Austin Kachpea visited the southeast part of the district to assess the impact of the disaster and now reports.
Been displaced, crops and road networks destroyed due to heavy floods which have also claimed 8 lives. At Sonjeka area, people have been rendered destitute, are seeking shelter nearby schools and churches, a situation which has forced schools to close, hence affecting education in the area. The headmaster of Mpala Catholic Primary School, Ed Tomato, explains more on the situation.
This has affected learning, teaching and learning at our school, because the moment these parents were gathered, faced this problem, they were brought to camp at the school. So they have occupied all the classes where learners were supposed to take their lessons. So since from Monday up to date, they are not learning.
Group village headman Mpuso confesses that life is becoming unbearable as they have nothing to eat, no potable water, and sleeping without blankets and mattresses. Parliamentarian for Mulanje South East Naomi Kilekwa points out that her area faces hunger as crops have been washed away, and appeals to non-governmental organizations, companies and faith community to assist the flood victims.
The people, they are in trouble in this constituency. And for sure, most of the people, they are camping in classrooms, others they are in churches, whereby they are lacking food there. They don't have even utensils there. So I'm asking those well-wishers to come in, please, to assist us to rescue people's life of this constituency, even to rescue their properties. Even if they can come with food, urgently, it can be better off.
Kilekwa, apart from donating food items and plastic bags, she has also brought some medical supplies as there is possible catching of waterborne diseases due to heavy floods sourced from World Vision Malawi.
Continued heavy rainfall has brought in havoc in most parts of the country, leaving thousands and thousands of people homeless and helpless. The Lower Shire is mostly affected, and Sanje Southeast has not been spared either. Patrick Tawakali caught up with parliamentarian for the area, Joseph Chindati Malunga, to explain the current situation in the area.
I think Sanje Southwest is one of those areas that has been badly hit. People running away into, on top of roofs of houses, roofs of schools, and rescue teams have actually evacuated some of these people. They've been put at a camp behind Sanje Secondary School. the Mother Angel camp. Food items are coming, trickling in slowly, but we need more because the situation is very bad. We want people to actually alleviate this situation. So we are actually appealing for all well-wishers, government, NGOs, CSOs to actually come and assist because the situation is very, very bad. We need food items, clothing, cooking utensils, and everything else that they think that people can use for the betterment of their lives.
Can you explain which areas are mostly affected by these floods?
We have particularly three traditional authorities, TA Malemia, TA Ngabu and TA Nyachikaza. These are the ones that have been very badly hit.
I mean the specific areas which are
affected. The specific areas is village Mpomba, village Ngwangwa, village Malikeza, village Chipwembwe, village Maguruguru, village Chataika. These are the ones that have been badly hit.
Malunga says despite the fact that his area experiences floods every year, but this year, even areas which never experience floods have been affected. Malunga has therefore appealed to urgent assistance for the affected households.
All well-wishers, government, NGOs, CSO, to actually come and rescue us. The situation is very bad, understand? With everything else, food items, clothing, shelter, we need tents, we need cooking utensils, pails, and all those things. Please come to Sanje Southwest, right at the Bomba. These activities are being coordinated by the district commissioner. So if you need any contact information or any kind of information, please contact the district commissioner for Sanje. Mr. Piri, I think, is the one who's doing all this coordination.
We now give you an update on government's response to the floods from the Office of the Vice President. The National Disaster Preparedness and Relief Committee, comprising of ministers, principal secretaries, senior MDF and police officials, and cooperating NGOs, World Vision, Malawi Red Cross Society, says most people who were stranded have now been rescued, but government continues to monitor the situation. A total of 442 community-based child centres have been temporarily closed due to the disaster affecting 28,007 children. Responding to this, government has moved in to provide tents, fortified consoya blend and high-energy biscuits to the children. A total of 415 schools have been affected, of which 234 had their roofs blown off, submerged or collapsed, and 181 school blocks are being used as camps. The government has, however, started providing tents in areas where displaced people are staying in schools in school blocks to ensure that learning is not affected. Efforts are being made to ensure that there is total coordination in terms of information flow with the district commissioners and the eight clusters that were formed to coordinate and manage the disaster response. Those willing to assist should channel their donations through the Department of Disaster Management Affairs and district commissioners. The DCs are the ones responsible for distribution of the relief items to the affected populace.